Well, with that, welcome everybody to the new game. Star Wars Bounty Hunter is my choice for the shorter alternative game that I talked about. And this definitely is a pretty big step in a different direction, I would say, as far as my videos are concerned. It's a very different game, very unheard of game. It's just a pretty big break from Kirby videos and Mario and Bomberman and whatnot. This is very different, mind you, but very definitely a good game in my opinion. So I would call it pretty underrated. I mean, most of the people I talked to that have played this game loved it. So, don't wanna see that again. But yeah, it's like I said, I think it's a very good game, very underrated and very unheard of. So this will be a nice kind of different step or different approach. I think, which is kind of nice. It's always nice to do something different. Anyway, just get started on a new file. If you can't tell already, this game follows the story of Jango Fett before the events that took place in the second movie, episode 2, Attack of the Clones, where I believe is the first time we see him. This all takes place before that. But anyway, I don't think there's anything we need to take care of. Options. Turn that down a bit, but I think that should just about do it. Just jump right in here. Treated to a very, very fitting opening cutscene.
Master?
Lord Tyrannus, an urgent matter has arisen that must interrupt your training. The Bandogora has become a dangerous parasite. It must be eradicated. I believe you once had the opportunity to eliminate its leader. Why did you not take it?
As an experiment?
The experiment has failed. This deranged former Jedi has no place in my vision for the future. I expect you to correct this error.
As you wish. And what of your plan for the clone army?
Our cloners require a host. You must find an ideal specimen, perhaps among the galaxy's most dangerous mercenaries.
I shall accomplish both of these tasks with a single stroke, Master.
Yes, yes. I look forward to completing your training, my friend.
Well then. Oh yeah, so in another cutscene following that.
What a contest this is turning out to be! Outland Station hasn't seen a brutal beast fight like this in a long time! The fearsome Morak has proven to be a formidable challenger! Its owner must be real, whoever he is! As Rosala's champion finally met its match tonight!
Master Jango, where are you?
A champion is in trouble! Ow! Oh, what a blow! and another! And the challenger wins! Oh, what a tremendous upset! What's this?
Nice try, Bet.
Dead or alive, Miko?
He's holding a remote! That's cheating! What an eye!
You want me? You gotta go through him first!
And to start us off, they just throw us into a boss fight. But this one isn't too bad, actually. Oh man, that cutscene took a lot of time, dang. But like I said, this isn't so bad. Come on, bring him on, I say. Do your worst. Big red bastard. Alright. At least it's, I guess it serves as a bit of a tutorial at first. Note that we don't have a jetpack to start us off, which is a bit of a bummer. It's pretty simple though. Let him run into one of the walls, then you can start shooting to actually deal damage. You can see a small little health bar, like a little indicator just below where he is when you're locked onto him. I'm pretty sure shooting at him just regularly doesn't do anything, so you have to wait till he's stunned by that electric field fence thing. Shooting him right here doesn't do anything, or even worse, just bounces off. Come on. Yeah, there you go. Slides right into it. Yeah, come on, one more. One more round and he's done. Whee! Can I get it? Oh, he's still going, just barely though. Man, I thought I could be all fancy about it too. Well, that works. Oh, whoops. Alright, well, that finishes him off. And I think... Did they disengage the... Oh, wait, no, it's right here. Alright, yeah, I think that's it. I think we're pretty much finished here. Open this gate, or door thing. Shazam! Let's see, what do we got here? Note that I'm playing this on the GameCube version. Partially because it's just easier since I just played on the Wii. And also because I don't have a PS2. So, you know, what are you gonna do? By some accounts I've read that the GameCube version has got better reviews. I don't know why, per se, but that's at least what I've heard. Can I just jump down? To drop into a level. Okay, I gotcha. Then down to jump. Whoops, I was probably supposed to jump on something else. But oh well, I didn't receive that much damage. These little guys running around here. Health. Yay, health. Wait, can I go down here? Oh, yeah, I can. I can't remember if this is the way we necessarily need to go, but if nothing else, it's a way to go. Can't tell if that's a light or... Well, let's go in. Why not? Feeling frisky. Oh, no, I guess just like a weird gas thing. To jump in. Oh, okay. Yeah, this is the way we need to go, actually. Huh. How lucky. Whee! Oh, I missed. Whoops. Let's try that again. Once more with feeling this time. There we go. Alright, much better. It's a lot of acrobatics and some pretty distinct platforming elements in this game, which is interesting. I said that I would, if nothing else, I would call it a platformer. Or, not a platformer, an action game, but... Yeah, details, as I'm always saying. Our little helper person, I can't remember her name, as she has just said, there are some bad guys here, but one of the big draws of this game is the bounty hunting aspect, hence the name, I suppose, where you in your inventory switch to this thing, bring it up on the heads-up display, and when you lock on to, let me zoom in here, when you lock on to people, and they have a a bounty on them. That's the namesake, I guess. You can lock onto them, and you can confirm that you've found them out, I guess, is what you want to do. And it depends. Oh, whoops. If they're wanted, you can see on the left side there, dead or alive. Alive, they're worth more. If they're wanted dead, you could just kill them and then collect the bounty. But if they're wanted alive, you have to do one of these measures.